Hi, you're listening to Phil DiBella, and this is FlashCast by PDB. And today, I thought it would be right to get my family together to do a special FlashCast around the coronavirus. And I've got my wife, Jana, joining me, Ali and Anika. Welcome to the show.
Hi.
Hello.
Of course, times at the moment, unknown times, unprecedented times. So I just want to share, and the purpose of this one was as a family to talk a bit about the coronavirus and get a kid's perspective and get a family perspective on how we feel and what's going on about it, and hopefully something you guys can play and share with your families and helps you guys gather some strength. And right now we're doing this after we've just finished dinner together around a table, which is one of the things that we're doing positively, is to spend more time one-on-one. But let me kick off by asking you, Jana, what's your biggest concern at the time right now?
My biggest concern is for the people that are particularly vulnerable, of which my sister is one of those people. She has bronchiectasis, so I'm really concerned about her, and also my mum, who's elderly. That's the thing that dominates my mind most.
And what advice have you passed on to them?
Well, they've been very good. They've stayed indoors and they're limiting their contact almost completely with other people other than their immediate family, including me.
Yeah, and that's something that I've done with my parents too. Mum's just had an operation on a hernia, and we've made sure they're staying indoors, and if they need anything, we'll bring it to them. And Wes self-isolated them away from the rest. So that's obviously message number one, is don't take this self-isolation thing as a joke. It needs to happen, especially for those most vulnerable. Anika, tell me, what's your thoughts on coronavirus right now from a 12-year-old perspective?
I personally don't like it because, obviously, not just me, but everyone can't really see their family and their friends because of distancing and other safety precautions.
What are you most worried about? As a 12-year-old right now, what worries you the most?
Definitely my auntie and my grandmother's health, and my other friends' families' health as well, since some of them vulnerable to it as well, and not being able to see my friends.
So, of course, a lot of people listening to this in the same position. So, what are things you're doing to stay close? To talk to them? I know you were talking to your grandma on the phone yesterday. What other things can people do to make sure that they stay in touch?
Well, I FaceTime some of my friends, and I send some messages to my auntie.
Yeah,
and
great.
Cousins.
Fantastic. Ali, and in a time now, obviously, it's important to stay connected. So you might not be able to see them and you need to self-isolate, but I think the key message there from Anika is still stay in touch. Use technology, embrace technology in a positive way to stay connected and let people know that you're there for them. Ali, tell me, you're 10 years old. What goes through your mind at the moment? Because this is something like this you've never been through, of course.
I actually think people are overreacting about this.
And why do you think they're overreacting?
Because, first of all, they're expecting kids to do the new social distancing rule. And obviously that has actually put some people in depression.
Okay, so that's a different perspective. So what's depression to you? So what's depression mean to a 10-year-old boy?
Negative thoughts.
Yeah.
And suicidal thoughts.
Okay. Do you think 10-year-old boys would be having those thoughts?
Not really. We're just waiting for something to happen because we're not adults yet and we can't really do anything about this.
So there's a bit of anxiousness because you guys are worrying about the unknown?
Yeah, I am worrying about what things to come. Like, people voted on a poll if we should go into full lockdown. 80%, mind you, over 100,000 people voted. 80% said yes, 20% said no. So
what you feel, and where was this poll taken? Where did you see this poll?
As a family, we watch the news, and I know 7 News is sometimes not the most reliable source.
Yeah.
But they ran a Facebook poll.
Okay. So what's your take on that? Do you think they should be listening to what the people want then?
Sometimes very important people can have a dimmer side. Or sometimes it can just be ridiculous.
Okay, well, it's an interesting perspective. But so obviously the most important thing, if you or your friends are going through these sorts of thoughts, is to what? Is to stay connected to people, ask questions, communicate. Would you agree?
Yes.
Have you been being there for your friends, talking to them?
Yes. I would have called my friend and see how he was doing, and my grandmother. But my grandmother, I didn't know, and sadly I didn't bother to ask if she was working or not. And my friends, I stayed home from school on the day that we're voicing this.
Okay, yeah, so you haven't had a chance to reach out to them. So, but you will, no doubt, and you need to make sure that you do reach out to them. Jana, based on what Ali's just said, and that's going to be in something I've been talking about, that I think that the mental health is going to be the biggest problem. Somebody who does a lot of mindset coaching is very well connected in this space. What would some of your tips and advice would be?
Well, I think we have to be very conscious of what we can influence, what we can control, and of those things, what we can action, and following that model, because if we focus too much on all the uncontrollables, that will definitely put people in a negative mindset and impact their health even further. So my message would be to focus on the things you can control and the things that you can influence, and stay connected, because human beings get their strength from each other.
And there's some good message there. Control what you can control, influence what you'd like to, and if you can't do either, then you need to let it pass. But staying connected and knowing that you've got people around you and reaching out to them in times of need. One of the things I talk about is, you know, we see how good people are and when the times are tough, because it's easy to be good when things are easy. Nobody's immune to this, and it doesn't matter whether you have a dollar or several millions of dollars. Nobody is immune. Everybody's going to go backwards in one way, shape or form. And if we all do what we can, and I've been talking about care and community, and that has to happen. Good spirits, do what you can. And I know a lot of people that are out there doing some amazing work, and especially through social media, where it's been used for positive in most ways, where people are getting the message out there of helping each other, helping family. Make sure that we keep that going. That's my advice, is to really understand care and community. Even our kids are doing this, doing good deeds for people, and reaching out and being there for people. It's very, very important that we stay connected. It's important that we understand that this shall pass, and it's going to pass if we all bond together and do amazing things. So, Annika, what would your message be to your audience, your 12-year-old audience, you know, or that young, you know, about to turn teenager or teenager? What would your message be to them from a positive perspective?
Definitely find things that make you happy and make you feel better when you're sad, and focus on good things and not the unknown and what could possibly happen, I guess.
Fantastic. That's really, really good advice. Ali, what would your message be to your people of your age group around being positive?
Well, keep in touch with your friends, stay happy, stay positive, and you'll get through this.
Yeah, very good. And Jana, what was your message to people?
Well, I think we've mentioned it a couple of times. Stay connected, and use this time to really connect with your family, because often there's so many more distractions that go on, but everything almost is cancelled. So now is our time where we can come together as a family, and I'm looking forward to that, and I hope the viewers, listeners do the same.
Yeah, and my message really simply is, we've all cancelled holidays. We all can't go out and wine and dine. Let's use the time to create positivity and bond together with family, with friends, obviously staying as isolated as you can, socialising with people in your own home that are healthy and all the rest of it. But really, think outside the square, be positive. And just because we're isolated or because we can't go and have those holidays or eat and drink in a restaurant doesn't mean that we can't do it at home. Put on the music, dance around, and carry on. Last thoughts, Jana?
I would stop watching the news, because the more news you watch, the more negative you become.
Yeah, I agree. Any last thoughts, kids?
Obviously focus on the good things in life and use things such as drawing, cooking, whatever makes you happy, and use the extra time.
Ali?
Wear your seatbelt.
Wear your seatbelt. Okay. Guys, you've been listening to Phil DiBella, Jana DiBella, Annika DiBella, and Ali DiBella. This is Flashcast by PDB. Stay safe, stay well, be smart,
care and community. Until next time, be the best you can be.